And if you want to live in the middle of the performance, you will be asked to give us some feedback in order for us to learn and improve from your comments. So, if you know that you will not stay for the whole hour, or if you have a problem with being fit, or if you don't feel like participating, we will give you 1 minute for you to leave now.
Because of the acoustics of the room, we would like to tell you that we have to speak one by one. It's better and we can communicate better if we speak one by one.
Maybe observe the people that are around you.
Thank you. Thank you.
you tell us why you feel comfortable? Sorry?
It's calm.
No, why you feel comfortable?
Because it's silent. It's nice to have silence.
Okay. There's no rush?
Mm-hmm.
There's no rush. No way.
We have generally noticed that in this space there is an inequality between the people that they feel comfortable and they most of the times they cover, and people who feel uncomfortable. So we had this idea, and we would like to hear from you also, like, ideas how to... Yes, yes. We have this tendency in this space of the comfortable people to take over more often. So we would like to hear from you, from both groups, ideas of how we're going to have an equality in the room, how we can make the people who don't feel so comfortable to feel more comfortable, in order to have more distributed voices here.
There could be more eye-to-eye contact to include all the people into it or something, to have them have them together but without language or something.
Something that makes people not feeling comfortable feel comfortable.
Like what?
I don't know. Maybe we should try to ask. If it's the situation or something specific we can change.
And maybe it's also a little bit individual what people don't or miss in this room who are feeling uncomfortable. I think what makes me feeling comfortable is connection to other people. And like, because when we close, like, after I opened my eyes, I felt less comfortable before than before, because like I lost somehow the connection. Like, I got it on one hand, but I think for me, to feel comfortable is really connected to see people, or maybe also talk to people, but. I think to get in connection, which I can definitely more or something. Like, I don't know, this.
First I felt uncomfortable because of the singing, because coming in a room with strangers and everyone is singing very intense, and in a very intense way, and you know, don't know anybody, that makes you feel uncomfortable. Then you are asked to go in one part of the room and everyone looks at you, that makes you uncomfortable too. But now I've seen everyone and I'm getting rid of the feeling that there's just an anonymous crowd, but individuals, and I'm getting more comfortable. No one seems to be harmful.
To me it helped that some people were smiling, so we could all see that we're in this together, and that, like, everybody's in the same situation right now, except for you and three people who've done this before.
Mm-hmm.
And maybe you have to ask the people who are comfortable to move, because everybody is lazy and people tend to stay, so less people move to the other room side. So you ask the uncomfortable people to move.
Okay.
So if you ask the other one to move, the comfortable people, maybe you have more equal distribution.
So we let the uncomfortable people stay still and the comfortable people move.
Example.
No, you mean to go
the other room.
This is a nice idea, actually. How would uncomfortable, how would comfortable people become uncomfortable?
Cool. Yeah, this was actually, in fact, why I changed the side, because first I was on the comfortable side,
But I felt very uncomfortable that these people feel uncomfortable.
Okay. It was solidarity to the uncomfortable.
Yeah, okay. I felt better when I came here.
Can't the comfortable people take their shoes off, for example?
Yeah. I don't think you want that.
No, do you mind?
After this day, never.
Do you mind to just to bring equality in the room, just to have the little room?
Not this kind of quality, please.
No. We can be more comfortable then.
Wait 1 minute, we have someone who wants to give some feedback.
Yeah, I don't want to be taken.
Yeah, but we said that the introduction.
I put my coat because I'm really ill.
Okay.
talking about the people that are now in the comfortable zone, that they feel comfortable. Okay, we can stay in this side of the room and move.
Thank you.
said, it's funny that everyone's whispering, and I said, yeah, I always have the feeling that I need to break silence. And then she was, my friend was saying, it's funny that everyone's whispering, and I said, yes, and I have the feeling of the need to break the silence. But then I also don't want to, or I shouldn't, but now I did.
Yeah, good job.
And then I said she knew that it's time to.
Feeling of what just happened. I would like to know, like this question we had in the beginning, to which side, which person wants to go. That would be interesting.
Very uncomfortable.
Uncomfortable or very uncomfortable.
Maybe I should have a chance to, you know, go to the other side.
I will suggest another category, people who feel instrumentalized and people who don't feel instrumentalized.
Instrumentalized.
Like an instrument,
yeah,
you feel like that.
Where
you have been conditioned.
This side of
instrumentalized
this? Oh, yes.
From here, non-instrumentalized from here.
And uncomfortable.
Okay.
Yes, that's my place.
Yes.
Situation that I don't want it to be, but it was not bad.
Which in the dancing or before?
Before, when I was closing my eyes and someone was touching me and forming me. So this was the period I felt very instrumentalized. But
so,
yeah.
Sorry, okay. I wanted to ask you
how you feel about. Oh, because you've been ordering around, what happened? That's how you have you've been since you arrived here. We're supposed to shout one tone, which is quite nice. But then we're supposed to be silent, we're supposed to sort of decide whether we're comfortable or uncomfortable, we're supposed to touch people or be touched by people. It's a bit like being ordered about. It's not very comfortable. And I think if this is not being instrumentalized, well, I mean, I don't know what it is.
Well, you knew that you would go and just like be here and be in the situation, so that's why I decided not to go. Because, like, I mean, it was clear that there would be orders, otherwise you could have left.
Sure, but I mean, is this about creating comfort or is it about not creating comfort? So I mean, I thought this was an experiment in trying to make people feel comfortable. And I didn't.
No, we're trying to interpret the score.
Well, yeah, sure.
We're trying to interpret the score here.
Sure, yeah. Well, the score is about, well, this is a bit of a complicated score for me, but the score goes...
you can read it.
Yeah. Listen carefully. The audience is your instrument. Play it in order to practically understand how we are generally instrumentalized. So it's quite successful. In that score. Prepare the audience with concepts, questions, and movements as a way to explore the dissonance that exists between the individual narcissism that capitalism promotes and our social capacity, between how we conceive ourselves as free individuals with agency and the way we are socially determined with capitalist relations, technology, and ideology. I suppose that was very good too. Reflect on the, well, that is quite oppressive, yeah? So it was quite successful in getting this through. Reflect on the I-we relation while defining social dissonance. I suspect I did all the time, yeah? I think most people did as well. You did, didn't you? Help the collective subject to emerge. Well, that bit of the score, I think it was very hard and maybe impossible. It's not that bad that it's impossible, but the rest was fine. I think we did it.
Well, everybody like a checklist of things.
Yeah. And maybe we still have to wait for the collective subject to emerge. Do you want to give it a go?
Me?
Yes.
Why?
Because somebody has to give a go on the collective subject.
Yes. I don't see it anymore.
I mean, doing something in a collective means doing it in a group, right? If you just tell me to do it and
you can facilitate.
But I think we are thinking in a group, so maybe this is somehow the collective subject. I don't have another idea about the collective subject. I noticed that in the dancing part, both sides, the comfortable and the uncomfortable, danced. So that was impressive for me, that it was kind of... The music works. I don't understand why, how, but it's clear that...
Also, a lot of people in the confident part didn't dance. Changed sides, but still didn't dance.
I think it's strange if the music is there and we don't dance, it's uncomfortable to do it.
Not to dance, not to play music.
Yeah.
So the music, it was the normalizer.
Are you feeling better after dancing?
I want to dance. Did someone feel worse after not dancing?
I think everybody felt a little bit worse when the music stopped, and during the silences, which originally were time for that people could use to introduce suggestions and ideas, as you did, for example, in the last moments of silence that we had, you suggested that we make again the groups. So it happened that somebody else gave an order. But today, I feel that we had many different, completely different parts and different situations which were cut in a very direct way. And in the music part,
I think everybody felt very much more comfortable than the other whole part. And it's like this specific, no? To me, yeah, I felt at least, so yeah. And this specific music piece, I don't know, it's made somehow to make you feel comfortable and open and blah, blah, blah. But in the part that the comfortable people close their eyes and the uncomfortable were touching them, At first I had my eyes closed and I felt a little bit more uncomfortable than before. So maybe this trial to equalize the two groups, maybe this was a good idea that you suggested, that we feel less comfortable in a way. And I don't know about uncomfortable people, if they felt more comfortable when we had our eyes closed and they could move us and do whatever they wanted.
I don't believe the people don't move if they really feel comfortable. I don't think so. I think the people who close the eyes, I think they are just, they think if they continue to close the eye, they are more comfortable than they open the eye and they just want to know what happened the next. But I don't think they are really comfortable and really.
In the beginning, for me, it was interesting, like to touch and persons. And after some time, I felt not very comfortable because I could do like everything with them, and it was like this power I felt I had above the others. And
I thought that was about
that's interesting that you say that, because I was in the other, like I was being touched,
yeah.
And the whole time I had the feeling that I could just open my eyes and say stop,
yeah,
right there, and
you could.
Why didn't
yeah,
you do?
Because I didn't feel the need to. Like I felt safe enough the whole time,
yeah.
Confident enough to not do it.
That's the same feeling. I didn't want it to break out, but I knew that
the
I could
the other
time
there.
There.
To that could give me safety.
It was like the whole time we were in a situation that you're not exactly comfortable and you're not exactly okay with what is happening, but it is this in the edge that if you move a bit forward, then something is going to change, but you don't. So like, this is how I felt most of the time, because it really felt uncomfortable, and I think when we were separated into groups, as a matter of energy and as a matter of how it felt, it didn't feel as if the more comfortable people were indeed more comfortable. It felt like we were the same. And I found interesting the fact that in order to overcome not being comfortable, we tried something that would give more power to the non-comfortable. And I don't know if, like, of course, feeling empowered is something that can make you more comfortable, but I'm not sure if this would be the solution,
meaning that,
to that problem.
Yeah, it's really paradoxical.
Yeah. And I felt very much manipulated by the song. It felt like my body could not resist at all, because it is like this fixed idea that, you know, when this kind of song is played, then you have to dance in a specific way, and it brings you to a totally different context. So I was amazed by how everyone, almost everyone, broke what they were doing at the time, like their stillness, in order to dance. Yeah, and as a question, as something that we could all think after leaving the space, is what could have been, what were maybe the power relationships inside the space? At some point someone says that cannot be equal because of the performers, and because the performers have more power in some way.
Yeah. I agree. I think I would act differently if performance, if you would have left, or all of you, and the camera would just have been somewhere.
Also the camera. can't. You have to talk about the camera. It's such a big difference.
I think I would forget about it if it would just be somewhere.
Is it like thought of as a part of the performance?
Of course.
As just documentary. Like,
No. It's definitely part of the whole thing.
Yeah. So we have to talk about that because it's so different. The entire group dynamics and people opened up would be different without the camera.
I'm not so sure, but it's interesting. Some days people say about the camera, some others don't. And it's interesting. It's a mediation, of course. I understand that you perceive yourself differently if you think that you're being watched. But we are embedded in so many mediations, and this is something that happens in your walk in London, for example. I don't know how many times you get filmed or like.
Yeah, that's on the internet. So in 50 years you become like use Google face
recognition and you can find yourself.
Yeah.
Also on the streets of London, yes.
True.
Possibly.
True. So I don't know, I think this is part of our contemporary...
Yeah, but what is strange, like when I start to speak, you just focus on me, right?
Mm.
And this is nothing you do when you're on the street. I mean, if someone is taking a picture and you're just stepping by, you're like, oh, sorry, but you don't really care if you're on the picture or not because this person wasn't interested in you and right now you focused on me, so
true.
This makes
true.
Me feel uncomfortable.
But also there is the language mediation.
But why? Like,
which is another one.
He would be looking at you anyway.
Yeah, but I see that he's holding this camera.
So she looks herself in me where I'm holding
the
camera.
Yeah, no, I get the idea. I don't.
You don't feel like...
No.
Yeah, because perhaps you don't feel uncomfortable seeing yourself on the tape, for example. I don't know. Because there are also people who don't like to be photographed.
No,
so.
No, I do sometimes also don't like myself on videos, but. Yeah, isn't this something you talk normally after performance, like to reflect and see?
Well,
I mean, we can talk about for hours afterwards, but I don't know.
I guess that's what it's about.
The conversation is after performance.
Mm-hmm.
I think.